Hi, my name is Ellie. This next year, I'm going to be a junior at Whitney Young. I've made an app that helps people track their plastic. I chose to make this app because I've always been very passionate about the environment, and I've recently seen the large amounts of waste that we as people produce every day. My goal in creating this app is to help people become more environmentally conscious by increasing the awareness of the amounts of waste that they produce. And as you'll see, in this app, there's a section to record the plastic that's used, as well as a place to learn more about plastic waste and its impact on our environment. I hope that people will use this app to help our Earth by reducing plastic waste, and I'm really excited to share it with you today. The first screen that you see when you open the app is the Create Account screen. From here, as a new user, you click the Create Account button. Clicking this button takes you to the Create Account page, where you enter the details for your account. You enter your first name, username, and then your password. When you click Submit, it verifies that everything's all good with your account details. You then go to the login screen, where you enter those account details. Once you press login, it opens up the app feed. In this feed, you can see the plastics that you've used and then logged into the app. You navigate this app by clicking on the various tabs on the bottom, but we'll start by logging a plastic. To do this, click the plus button in the bottom right corner. This will open up a selection where you can select which items to add to the feed. So we'll start by choosing a small baggie that, let's say, I just used. When you click it, it gets added to the feed. Displayed on the feed is not only the item that you logged, but also the date and time that it was logged into the app. Now we can click the plus button again and look at the other options in that selection menu. At the top, you can see two non-plastic options, back and add item. The back option does what you... Sorry about my dog. The back option does what you expect and takes you to the feed screen. Using the other option, add item, you are able to add custom items to the selection menu. If we click that button, it takes you to a new screen where you can add custom items. So for example, let's say that I used 6 ounces of plastic packaging today. I can type that in, and when I click submit, it will be added to the list. We can go back and see that, and you can see it's now the bottom item. You can click on that item like any other and it will be added to the feed. We can also continue adding items as you use them throughout the day. The next part of this app is the settings page, which you can access by clicking the gear button in the top right corner. Currently, there are 3 settings options. The first is an About This App section and includes a little information about the making of the app. The next option is the Edit Plastic List button, which is currently a work in progress. I didn't have enough time during the Code Your Dreams program to figure out the code behind this, but I think if this app were to be created and used widely, it's a very important part that would be very important to the app. If someone, like say, mistypes when they're adding a feature or when they're adding a plastic into the list, they want to be able to edit that or maybe take out a plastic that they don't use anymore. The last option is to log out, which is pretty clear. If you click yes, it takes you back to the first welcome screen. And if you click no, it just stays here. Next part of this app is the Learn section. Here, there are some different articles about plastic use and plastic waste on this earth. You can scroll through these articles and see all the different ones. And in making this, I did a bit of research and I included articles from different sources about different things relating to plastic waste. You can click on the bolded title of each article, and you'll be taken to the full article in your phone's default web browser. Next is the data section that's accessed by clicking on the data tab. This page is currently a bit empty. I would have liked to add more to this, but I didn't have enough time. Currently shown here is when you joined and how many plastics you've logged. Ideally, I would have loved to include some graphs here showing each user's trends, including the number of plastics they've logged each day with different quote-unquote views, a week, month, maybe even year. Also, a section that shows if they frequently log certain plastics. But we used MIT App Inventor to make these apps, and there wasn't an easy way for me to implement that. The next part is the Explore tab. This is also something that I wasn't able to add more to. Ideally, it would show you and your plastic waste and people around you, but there were lots of privacy questions that came up regarding sharing your location, so I didn't implement this part of the app. Back to the feed screen. As you use this app, you'll be able to see that, oh, on Monday, I used 5 different pieces of plastic, but on Tuesday, I only used 3. And the user becomes more aware of how much plastic they use and hopefully wants to reduce this number. In conclusion, I hope that when people use this app, they will work towards reducing their plastic waste and becoming more environmentally aware. Thank you.